volumes of pyramids and cones, a la Shmoop. Pharaoh Tut is on his way to the hereafter, and he may have overdone it with his list of things to bring to the underworld. Talk about a bucket list. Help him calculate the volume of his pyramid, so he'll know if he's going to have to leave some stuff behind. The length and width of the base are 10 meters, and the height of Tut's pyramid is 12 meters. The volume of a pyramid is one-third the volume of the prism with the same base. Because we have a square base, we know that its area is length times width, which is just 100 meters squared. We plug that into our formula and solve for the volume. 1/3 times 100 times the height of 12. 100 times 12 equals 1200 divided by 3, which equals 400. That's 400 cubic meters. His neighbor Pharaoh Irving is going to meet his maker in a cone rather than a pyramid, so he'll have to use the formula 1/3 pi times radius squared times height to find the volume of the cone. If we look closely at the volume formula of a cone, it looks a lot like the volume formula of a pyramid. Since pi times radius squared is the area of a circle, which is the shape of a cone's base, and b is the area of the base of a pyramid. If the radius of the cone's base is 10 and the height is 12, we can plug them into our formula. 1/3 times pi times 10 squared times height equals 1/3 times pi times 100 times 12. Then you get 1200 divided by 3, which equals 400. So our answer is 400 pi. Since 400 pi is bigger than 400, looks like Pharaoh Irving is really going to be the one living the good life, afterlife. Subscribe to check out more equally fantabulous videos. You should see the subscribe button just below this one. If you're having trouble locating it, we recommend you watch our video, How to Find the Subscribe Button.